Hey viewers, in today's video I'll compare mods that add AK pattern rifles into Fallout 4, and determine which ones are actually worth using. I've got 8 mods to cover today, listed on screen right now. There's definitely a few AK mods I missed, probably even some good ones, but I can't cover everything, and if I have to go to somebody's Discord or Patreon to download a mod, you can count me out. I'm not doing that. Anyhow, let's move on to my recommendations. If I had to choose just one of these mods to keep loaded in my game, it would have to be AKM Complex. It's the only mod I found that truly has the customization potential one would expect from a Kalashnikov. And it doesn't have any major issues, certainly nothing you couldn't fix yourself in 5 minutes in Fallout 4 edit. AKM Complex is my recommendation, but let's take a look at all of these mods in detail just because we can. First on the list is AK-74M Assault Rifle. This weapon has two unique variants, an AKS-74U that can be found at Spectacle Island on top of the shipping containers in a locked gun case, and a radioactive version called Frontliner that can be found inside this secret room at the capsized factory in the Glowing Sea. Besides these two uniques, this weapon has leveled list injection. You can find it in stores or on legendary drops. Failing that, you can craft it at a chem lab with a vanilla assault rifle and some junk. This weapon looks pretty good, and I love its nice bouncy animations, especially the third-person animations. They're perfect. Unfortunately, in first-person power armor, this weapon has not only the double footsteps bug, but it also uses gamma gun animations, which are completely broken. Things are a bit better in third-person power armor since it uses handmade rifle animations. The charging handle might be on the wrong side, but whatever. This is a smaller issue, but when throwing grenades in third person, the magazine gets thrown out of position for a second. In terms of attachments, the Frontliner unique cannot be edited at a workbench, but the regular AK-74M has 5 receivers, 1 barrel, 4 stocks, 5 magazines, 12 sighting options, a suppressor and flash hider, a flashlight, laser sight, or combination of both, damage cheats, and 7 camo materials. That's not a whole lot of attachments, and none of them change the weapon very much. The unique AKS-74U has fewer but different attachments. It has the same 5 receivers, but 4 barrels, 2 stocks, 3 magazines, a cobra sight, a suppressor, flashlight, and laser sight, as well as damage cheats. Again, not many attachments and they aren't very transformative. In conclusion, while I like the animations, this weapon has issues in power armor and doesn't live up to the modularity you would expect from an AK. Our second mod is AKM Assault Rifle. It's packaged as loose files, so be wary about that. It comes with a Nuka World ESP that changes the ammo type to 7.62. If you don't have Nuka World or want to use 308 ammo, delete that ESP. This weapon has one unique variant called Bandit, which can be found at Gunner's Plaza. It also has leveled list injection. You can find it on vendors, on raiders, gunners, and legendary enemies in general. If you can't find it out in the world, you can craft it at a chem lab, again, out of a vanilla assault rifle and some junk. I think this weapon looks beautiful, and it arguably has better first-person animations than the previous mod, while using the exact same excellent animations in third-person. And unlike the last mod, this weapon's animations work in power armor with no double footstep glitch. There is tons of clipping, but I can live with that. Third-person power armor once again uses handmade rifle animations, and the grenade throw magazine bug is still present. But those still aren't huge issues. This mod adds a bayonet knife that uses knife animations and can be modified at a workbench with 3 blade upgrades and damage modifiers. It's not really worth using, but it's a cool little bonus weapon, I guess. As for attachments, we have semi or full auto fire, 3 barrels, 4 stocks, 7 magazine types, which all have different animations, 7 sighting options, a bayonet, a suppressor, and damage modifiers. The Bandit unique has 1 extra stock, but is otherwise the same as the base weapon. This mod is a way better choice than the AK-74M, but it still doesn't satisfy my itch for a highly modifiable AK platform. If you only care about animations and appearances, this could be the AK mod for you, just be sure to pack it into a BSA. Our third mod is AK-5C, a Nordic Relic. This one has 2 unique versions. One is a Christmas-themed weapon called the Special Snowflake, which can be found at Diamond City. However, it can only be found if the in-game day is December 25th, and I didn't want to waste time skipping the days, so I did what any normal person would do and spawned it in. There's another unique variant called Bluebird, which can be found at General Atomics Galleria if you do this stupid quest to find 4 pieces of blue tape. I looked for the tape for half an hour before realizing I still had 5 mods to look at after this, and I was running out of time, so I gave up and spawned in that unique as well. Besides the uniques, this mod adds dozens of magazines and secret documents throughout the world that will unlock new modifications for your AK-5. When starting the game, you can choose to have the locations of these collectibles revealed with quest markers, but even with the help, I have neither the patience nor the time to collect all this crap. I had to spawn it all in. In a full playthrough though, finding this stuff could be a very fun side activity. Beyond all that, this weapon has level list injection, it appears on gunners and raiders as well as on vendors. It's only injected after you complete this mod's quest at the third rail. Again, I didn't do that either. I can't fault the appearance of this weapon, and the animations are pretty good, but not as good as our first two mods, in my opinion. In third person, when you throw a grenade, the weapon parts explode out of the gun even more than the previous two mods. In third person power armor, this mod uses submachine gun animations, which don't look so great, but again, what are you gonna do? As a little bonus, this mod adds a Mora knife, which uses knife animations and can't be modified, so it's not much to look at. You could find this knife on enemies sometimes, since it's been injected into leveled lists. This weapon has a lot of attachments, 8 receivers, 3 barrels, 3 stocks, 5 magazines, 8 sight options, and you can change the reticle for your sights, 5 muzzle devices, 12 stickers, 2 foregrips, 3 bayonets, flashlights and lasers, semi or full auto fire, there's tape wraps, damage cheats, zoom levels for your scopes, and 13 skins. That's a lot of attachments, but a lot of them are just meme garbage like the Swedish herring magazines. Still, this weapon is great. You can definitely trick it out more than any other weapon on this list. And finding all the collectibles sounds like an interesting side activity to me, even if I didn't have time to do it for this video. This is probably the second best weapon on this list. Okay, fourth up is the Krebs AK. It has both 4K and 2K textures. You know I recommend a 2K version. This weapon has no unique variants, but it does have leveled list injection. Look for it on gunners, raiders, or at weapons vendors. Failing that, you can again craft it out of an assault rifle at the chem lab. I wonder what mod came up with that idea first. The model looks pretty good, and the animations are good too, except for the bash, which looks like it's missing some frames, it's way too snappy. But there's no problems in power armor. In third person, we've got handmade rifle animations. Sadly, this weapon also has the magazine issue when you throw a grenade. At this point, I was getting confused as to why every single one of these weapons has the exact same animation problem. So I looked back at the vanilla handmade rifle and... wow. Bethesda, how the hell did you let this get past QA? Oh man. As far as attachments, this weapon only has 5 receivers, 2 barrels, 3 stocks, 1 magazine, 7 scopes, a suppressor, a vertical grip, damage sheets, and 6 materials. So there's not that much customization with this weapon. I'm not a fan of it, there are way better options on this list. Our fifth mod is Elysium AK. This weapon has no unique variants or leveled list injection. Instead, literally the second you start a new game, you are given a quest to retrieve the Elysium AK. Yeah, sorry, I'll have to take a 200-year rain check on that. Anyways, the AK can be found inside a house next to the Peabody home, by a skeleton. You can also craft the Elysium AK at a chem lab, making this quest completely pointless. I don't think this weapon looks too bad, but it's just an AK with futuristic crap bolted onto it. Third-person animations are the same as the AK-74M mod, but the first-person animations are different and kind of worse in my opinion. In power armor, we've got handmade rifle animations in third person, and lots of clipping and some weird idle transition problem in first person, but that's not so bad. Of course, the weapon still tries to turn itself into a bullpup every time you throw a grenade in third person, but we're done talking about that. I can't even believe this bug is in the game. Well, actually, I can believe it because this is Bethesda we're talking about. Anyhow, this weapon has almost no attachments. There's 5 receivers, 1 ugly barrel, 1 stock, 2 magazines, no sights, no muzzle attachments, a laser sight, damage sheets, and 4 ammo types. That's all we get. This is one of the worst mods on this list. Don't download it. Sixth on the list is my recommended mod, AKM Complex. Make sure to download its update file as well as the Purple Scopes patch if you're unlucky enough to not have an NVIDIA GPU. This weapon has 3 unique variants. A 10mm variant called Prizrak 9 can be found at the Decayed Reactor Site in the Glowing Sea. Another variant called the AK-74 can be found at the Railroad HQ next to some ammo for it. The third variant called Exodus can be found inside Park Street Station near the entrance to Vault 114. In addition to the AKM, this mod adds a Tokarev TT-33 pistol, which is a nice little bonus. The AKM is injected into leveled lists, but the Tokarev is not. It can only be crafted at a chem lab. Everything else can be crafted at a chem lab too, including the tons of new ammo types this mod adds, which won't play nice with caliber complex or munitions, but of course, since this is a popular mod, there are patches available for whatever ammo overhaul you want to use. This weapon has a great model, and it uses the same animations as the Krebs AK. Aside from an ugly bash animation and the ubiquitous grenade throwing problem, there are no major issues with this weapon's animations, just some clipping and first-person power armor, and the disappointment of handmade rifle animations in third-person power armor. But that's all par for the course. This weapon has a crazy amount of mods, 8 receivers, 11 barrels that totally change the shape of the weapon, 4 pistol grips, 11 magazines, 14 scopes, 9 muzzle devices, 5 reticle styles for some of the scopes, 11 ammo types, 10 stocks, a flashlight or laser sight, and a bipod. You can make this weapon an SMG, a marksman rifle, an infantry rifle, an LMG, a stealth weapon, anything you want. The customization is great, but there's even more to cover because the Tokarev pistol has 7 receivers, 2 barrels, 3 grips, 3 sight options, 3 suppressors, 10 ammo types, and 5 reticle styles. That's not bad for a little bonus weapon no one cares about. This is definitely the best AK mod on the list, nothing else even comes close. But if you want something more modern and tactical, 7th we have Zenit Re-Redux. This is a massive weapon mod, at over 1 GB in file size. Almost all of that space is taken up by massive 4K textures. If you're on a lower end machine, I would highly recommend using a Cathedral Assets Optimizer to shrink those down to 2K or 1K. This mod adds 3 separate weapons, the AK-74M, AKM, and AK-12. All 3 are injected into leveled lists, but there aren't any unique variants. These models are beautiful, and the animations are probably the best I've seen so far. All 3 weapons have the same animations, though. Unfortunately, in first-person power armor, the double footsteps bug is present, and there is no patch available to fix it. In third-person power armor, we're getting handmade rifle animations, as expected. Now, these 3 weapons have a lot of attachments. This is going to take a while. For the AK-74M, there are 20 receivers, 26 sights, 6 laser sights, 2 underbarrel flashlights, 9 magazines, 13 muzzle devices, 8 pistol grips, 21 handguards, 14 stocks, 2 materials, and damaged sheets. The AK-12 has 10 receivers, 23 sights, the same 9 magazines, 14 muzzle devices, 6 laser sights, 11 underbarrel grips and flashlights, 8 pistol grips, 4 handguards, 14 stocks, 3 materials, and damaged sheets. The AKM has 10 receivers, 6 sights, 8 magazines, 11 muzzle devices, 8 pistol grips, 24 handguards, 7 stocks, 2 materials, and damaged sheets again. That all sounds great, but most of these attachments are visual only and don't fundamentally change the role these weapons play. Also, the scopes require see-through scopes, which I absolutely loathe. I know a lot of people will prefer this mod over AKM Complex, but for me, AKM Complex is way better than this mod. Oh, we're at the end of the list already. Last and least is AK-1112. This weapon is injected into leveled lists, and a unique version called Natalia can be found on the corpse of a Vault Dweller at the Vault Tech Regional HQ. If you're going to download this weapon, do yourself a favor and go to the optional file section and get the 2K version instead, because this weapon's model is way too ugly and blocky to waste a 4K texture on. It's hideous. I know that this design is lore accurate to the older Fallout games, but holy crap. The design did not age well. This thing is ugly as sin. And it uses vanilla handmade rifle animations, which aren't very good. And there's not too many attachments either. 14 receivers, 4 barrels, 4 stocks, 4 magazines, 9 scopes, 4 muzzle devices, and 3 skins. That's it. This weapon is awful. It's the worst option on this list. Alright, that's the end of my video. I really hope you found this comparative analysis useful. I certainly did. I never know which mods are going to be gold or garbage until I try them myself. And then I pass the information on to you. And so, until next time, toodles!